Hello everyone, myself Professor Nilesh Khade and I work as a full-time lecturer in Gokte College of Commerce. I am going to teach you Goods and Services Tax. Now this Goods and Services Tax, I will be focusing more on Rani Chennamma University Belagavi syllabus. Now the syllabus objective states that to equip the students with knowledge of Goods and Services Tax, it means we are equipping you students to understand what is this Goods and Services Tax and have the knowledge of it. That is the first objective, and second objective is to make BCom students more knowledgeable in the field of GST so that they can be self-employed as tax consultants or practitioner. This is the objective given by Rani Chennamma University. It says that we should give you so beautiful knowledge of GST that you are going to practice it. You are going to practice the taxation in near future. Now we are understanding the syllabus unit by unit. Unit 1 is introduction to GST. Here we are going to learn present indirect tax structure, problems of indirect taxes, needs for introduction of GST, definitions of GST, meaning of the term GST, and then commodities to be kept outside the purview of GST, other indirect taxes that will continue post GST, and then dual model of GST. We have this CGST, SGST and IGST model, and the features of GST. This will be your unit number 1. Other than this, we will be giving you more knowledge so that you will understand this GST in depth. Unit 2, extent and definitions of GST. Section 1 in any act will speak about the scope of that act. In GST Act, we have section 1 which will speak about scope of GST, and then definitions. Section 2 in every act will speak about the definitions. For your syllabus, we have these 10 definitions: actionable claim, address of delivery, address of records, adjudicating authority, agent, aggregate turnover, agriculture, agriculturist, appointed day, and assessment. These 10 definitions are there in unit 2 for you to understand the GST. And then unit 3, exemptions from GST. Meaning of exemptions, and then exempted suppliers, out of scope suppliers. Now there are three classifications, further classifications: unregistered business, deemed business enterprises, government department and other public sector bodies. We are going to understand the exemptions on supply of such goods and services, whether GST is applicable on it or not. And then categories of exemptions. We are going to categorizing those exemptions which are given by GST Act. Merit-based exemptions, or it is also called as concessional exemptions. We are giving concession, or we are giving such exemptions to such suppliers who are going to help the country, right? And then technical exemptions. These are the two classifications which was made in Model GST Act. In present GST Act, which is GST Act 2017, this does not classify the exemptions. Okay, this is based on, this chapter is based on Model GST Act 2016, right? However, you know, even if it is not there in the current GST Act, the logic of this is still there. And how this logic is applicable, we will see in unit number 3, whenever we are going to learn it. And then immovable properties and financial services. Is any exemptions available on immovable properties, or are there any exemptions on financial services? We are going to learn this in unit number 3. And then most important chapter, registration under GST. Here we are going to learn the meaning and types of registration. Then compulsory registration, section 24 of GST Act. Section 27, casual dealer and non-resident supplier. There we are going to learn who are these casual dealer and non-resident supplier. And then registration process for new applicants, right? What is the procedure? What are the time limits? Everything we are going to learn in detail, dot by dot, in this chapter, okay? Unit number 4 for you. compounding dealer, and then blacklisted dealer, surrender of registration, cancellation of registration. You know, this chapter is based on section 22 to section 30 of CGST Act and relevant rules, right? See, this is unit number 5, supply of goods and services under GST. Here we are going to learn what do you mean by supply of goods and what do you mean by supply of services. See, the whole GST is based on supply itself, the concept of supply. If you do not understand the supply, what a supply means, what a supply of goods or what a supply of services mean, you do not know any of the GST provisions. Right? So condition, is there any condition or conditions for taxability of supply of goods and services under GST? We are going to learn those conditions. Section 7 in CGST Act deals with the supply of goods and services. Right? And then there are three schedules only meant for the supply. There are three schedules only meant for supply in the Act. Now you understand the importance of this word called supply in GST. Supply in economics is different. Supply in GST is different because we define it like that. Okay, and what is the definition? We are going to learn that in unit number 5, right? And then place of supply of goods and services. See, place we have to learn because we have dual model of GST, and therefore because dual model of GST are there, dual model means central government and state government, both will go hand in hand to levy and collect GST. Now, if central government and state government both are involved, then we have to actually learn where the supply is being made. Is it made within the state or is it made outside the state? Now, for different services, for different goods, there are different rules. Now, what are those rules? We are going to learn that in unit number 5. And then, see, principles of GST. This is also based on Model GST Act, but still there are principles which we are following blindly, and these are such principles where you are going to understand why this GST is applicable here and why GST is not applicable in some other cases. There are different cases, and whether GST is applicable, you have to look after the principles. Okay, and then the rules. Okay, place of supply for goods and place of supply for services, right? Electronic mode, if it is made through electronic mode. This is the syllabus given by Rani Chennamma University, Belagavi. And yes, this is what the discussion of syllabus.